Three local men in positions of trust and power are now accused of sex crimes against kids. Good afternoon. I'm Jim Payne.
I'm Martha Sigalski. First at four, a high school coach, a youth pastor, and a former teacher are charged with sexually abusing children. WESH News' Dave McDaniel reports Polk County deputies say two of the cases involved the same victim.
Rumors have been swirling around Lakeland about the head football coach at George Jenkins High School. Now he's been arrested, accused of having sex with a 17-year-old girl.
30-year-old Matt Thompson didn't say a word as he was hauled off to jail, accused of sex battery with a student. Deputies say the high school teacher and head football coach told the victim she had to keep their relationship quiet.
He said, "If you tell anyone, I'll lose my job. If you tell anyone, I'll go to jail."
Investigators say they have him on tape talking about the illegal contact. He denies the accusation. He's suspended with pay while the district investigates. This student was aware of the accusation.
You can't take advantage of women and like their youth. I mean, he has no right to like be in this profession if that's his so he wants to do.
Also, two unrelated cases involving the First Assembly of God in Mulberry. 27-year-old Ricardo Navarro, a youth minister, is accused of trying to convince a 14-year-old to send suggestive pictures of herself to him. He's also accused of kissing her and trying to touch himself with her hand. He's confessed to only asking for sexy photos. And 30-year-old Edward Demaretta is accused of improper contact with the same girl back when she was only 13. He was a teacher at the time at Mulberry Middle School, where he's accused of convincing her to engage in oral sex. After he left the school, he also became a youth minister at First Assembly. The new pastor there helped the authorities with both cases. The sheriff spoke of this apparent betrayal of trust.
This community, this society is not going to tolerate that conduct.
The sheriff is concerned that in all three cases there could be other victims out there. He encourages anyone with information to come forward. Reporting in Lakeland, Polk County, Dave McDaniel, WESH News.